Welcome back to Star Wars Nerds Unite, a discussion and review podcast focused on the Star Wars universe. I'm your host, Tim Van Autriv. Joining me, as always, Josh the Tosh, internet famous Mason.
Hello.
And Jennifer Van Autriv.
Hi.
Hi. We also have Max as co-star today in a very baby-unfriendly recording studio because of poor planning. And our normal babysitters are not here. So if you hear odd banging or crying or screaming.
Your normal babysitters are your other children.
Right.
They're not really babysitters. They're siblings.
But I mean, they're sitting the baby.
No, they're watching their brother. They're not babysitting.
What?
Babysitting has a connotation that there's an exchange of funds for a service provided.
I let them live.
Right. So it's a de facto demand of their existence. It's not commerce. Commerce is not occurring.
Okay, whatever, doesn't matter.
Yeah, our kids are gone, besides Max, so...
Nolan's down there.
Nolan tries to watch him, but...
He ends up every 30 seconds going, oh my god! No, yeah. Max, no! And like...
He overreacts
sprinting.
To things. But he doesn't keep him... I mean, he keeps him happy for short periods, but it wouldn't have worked out.
All right. Well, we're going to be talking about Captain Phasma, the limited series. It was a journey to the Last Jedi comic book. I didn't get it pulled up here. It is written by someone. Do you have it up?
No, I don't have it up.
All right.
Sorry.
That's okay. I had it. It was supposed to be like queued up. Oh, well. Anyway, who's going to do the synopsis?
Josh.
I can. It's a really easy synopsis.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, this is one that I would be really good at.
So I read it in trade paperback form, as I think all three of us did.
Yeah, because I think that's how we're going to be purchasing the comics moving forward.
So my only comment on that is there weren't like natural breaks in the story. So I don't know how they split this up into comics.
Well, you can tell.
I kind of just blasted through it, so I don't pay attention to those extra splash screens. They've vanished from my memory. So this comic picks up right in the middle of The Force Awakens.
Was the writer Kelly Thompson and the artist was Marco Cicchetto?
That's correct.
It picks up right after Phasma gets thrown down a garbage compactor chute and after she let the shields down. It's kind of told in a, I can't remember what this technique is called, but it's a flashback basically. Phasma is producing her report, her record basically of the events that occurred on Starkiller Base and thereafter up until the point that she returns to the First Order. And so she's retelling or reimagining this story and telling it to us. And
it starts 6 minutes before the weapon of Starkiller Base is fully charged.
Right. She blasts out of the garbage compactor and goes back to the terminal to see if anyone else has accessed it. Basically, she's going to delete her records, any records of her releasing the shields. But one other person, a Lieutenant Sivas or something, I don't remember. His name's insignificant. He accessed the terminal after she did. And so she deletes any record of her messing with it. And she is going to lay the blame on this guy. And so she... The base is starting to collapse and destroy itself and explode. But she goes off looking for this guy, this lieutenant, because she needs to basically eliminate the loose ends of her little cover-up.
Yeah, because she doesn't want anyone to know that she's the one that lowered the shields.
Because she's a survivor.
That's right.
That's the thread of this book.
Did we ever do the Captain Phasma book for the podcast?
No.
I don't think so.
It would have been good, because there was callbacks to it in here.
He sees, like, she takes a shot at him and he escapes. they end up getting up onto the surface, and she sees Rey and Kylo fighting, lightsaber dueling on the surface of the planet. But she trudges on after this lieutenant. They eventually get to like a fighter,
like a small base, hangar.
Yeah. And he steals a TIE fighter, and Phasma takes the other fighter with a pilot. And it's one of the two-seater ones, the Special Forces version of the TIE that Finn and Poe use to escape the Finalizer. They go off. They don't have a hyperdrive, if I recall correctly. The other TIE fighter, its hyperdrive was broken. But Phasma's TIE fighter doesn't have weapons. So they kind of have to chase him at sublight speed until he runs out of fuel and lands on this planet that I don't remember the name of. It's like this rocky, rainy, kind of desolate planet. They end up finding...
It's a lot of water.
There's a lot of...
It's Luprora.
Luprora. They end up finding like remnants of a civilization and eventually get to a small town, I would call it, with the this humanoid species that are living on the planet. They're not originally from the planet. They kind of colonized it or attempted to colonize it. But they're getting wiped out by the actual indigenous species, which are more,
this
I'm going
to
call, fish-like.
This planet reminded me of like Theon's...
Like the
land,
the Greyjoy's. Yeah. What's that? It's Pike's the capital, but it's the Iron Islands.
Yeah, that's what it reminded me of.
Yeah, I could see that.
But they used to, like, they came to the planet with technology, obviously, but they thought technology was evil. So
because it destroyed their previous planet.
Right. So they destroyed it all as soon as they got there.
All their ships, save one, bar one. Phasma. So the guy, this lieutenant dude, had been captured by the indigenous species, and the I can't remember. I'm going to call them the colonists. The colonists were like super afraid of this indigenous species because they're just way more acclimated to the climate. They can
stop it.
Oh, like we said, there's lots of water. So like when the tides, there's like these global tides, and when the tides are up, these indigenous species come out and just wreck shop. So Phasma convinces, she like summons all of her charisma and gives this valiant speech to the colonists to explain how they need to stand and fight or they're going to be destroyed forever. But for her, it's just this giant diversion to go find this lieutenant to kill him, basically. So they end up getting to this, I don't know what to call it. It's like, yeah, that. It's like a giant plateau in the middle of the ocean that is their base. And a battle breaks out and all the colonists are fighting the indigenous people, and Phasma and the pilot go off and find this lieutenant dude. But this pilot, like, she, over time interacting with Phasma, she's kind of like fallen for the whole speech. And Phasma, the pilot's like, hey, you really, we need to defend these people. We need to help them. And they're following you. And Phasma's like, no, they're going to die anyways, eventually.
Yeah, she's like, yeah, I just sped it up a little bit.
So they might as well serve some purpose. And that's my purpose of murdering this guy. And they murder the dude. They go to their TIE fighter.
They don't. The
Phasma does.
The pilot sees what happens.
But whether the pilot saw it or not was irrelevant, as Phasma states later. But yes, the pilot does see it. The jig is up. But she doesn't want to confront Phasma because she knows she'll just get killed. Because that's... The lieutenant, while she's overhearing it, the lieutenant's like, you let the shields down, Phasma. I don't have to tell anybody. And she's like, you won't tell anybody. Pew, pew. And he's dead. They get back to the TIE fighter, and Phasma ends up shooting the pilot to tie up all loose ends. and then takes the TIE fighter and flies back to the fleet and gives her report. And Grievous buys it. And that's
Grievous.
Grievous. Hux. I just thought General Grievous. General Hux is like, well done, Phasma.
I knew you would be helping the First Order.
Yeah. So the cover-up is complete. And that's where we're at. The lead-in to The Last Jedi, basically.
Yeah. Phasma's a scumbag.
Yeah.
I never read the Phasma book.
She's very after her own self-interest.
I didn't like this at all.
She does have a knack for finding sweet armor, though.
Yeah, she did find a sweet suit of armor so that we could never see her face.
When they first get on that planet, they get stranded, like, whatever, they get out and they see deserted buildings, and they go in there to look for clothing to try to fit in with the indigenous people.
No.
And Phasma finds this super awesome...
the prison down.
Super awesome suit. It looks like some kind of armor that would have been in Star Wars Galaxies.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
How many comics was this when it originally launched?
5.
I see that. I just cannot.
Oh, no. It's 4.
Even 4 seems like they really segmented the story, and like there wouldn't be natural climaxes or anything. It's like it feels like this was probably a not great comic to read.
Yeah, 1 month at a time for sure.
Because there's just not a whole lot that happens.
No, there's really not. I don't know. There was a scene where like there was a great grandmother she had been born in the stars and she was the oldest person there. And
it's how they went and got all the weapons.
She was the only one that knew where the ship was.
The last ship that they didn't destroy all of their technology.
That was the only.
They left one ship. Carrying that had a bunch of weapons and armor in it.
But there's what's the necklace? She wants the necklace. Phasma wants it. She says, "Where can I find more of this?"
I think she's talking about just technology.
Oh, okay.
In general, because the necklace like
floats.
Yeah.
Okay, I get it.
There was one like weird scene when Phasma and the pilot were climbing up the steep
mountain, like a hill,
and there was like Phasma was having a flashback to when she was a kid or something,
right. Yes.
And I thought like we're gonna get her like backstory and find out why she's such like a horrible person, but like it didn't ever nothing happened with it, like they didn't explain anything.
It was just a little tease.
It's stuff from the book, the Captain Phasma book.
Okay.
And also I think it was attempting to try and show a deepening relationship between the pilot and Phasma to make the final act where she just kills her in cold blood.
I don't think that's quite what it was. I think it was more Phasma was constantly saying that the planet was very familiar to her, like it was very similar to her as a child. And it was showing how even with familiarity and that how her people were basically very similar to this, where they're stranded and dying, and she still manages to just push through any sort of feeling and be devoid of emotion and just do what's in her best interest instead of helping people.
So did her mom die in that book entry?
That's not her mom. I don't think. And I'm pretty sure her mom was dead. I don't even know if her mom was in that book that I can remember.
So then who's the chick?
It was just
I thought it was maybe her sister or something.
No, they were like this really tight-knit group of people. And they all acted like family. Like,
gotcha.
Because there were so few of them that they all just...
Yeah.
They were family. So that's how they acted to each other. But
are there any extra pieces of microphone equipment that I can let him play with? He is going crazy about this.
I don't think we have any extra pop filters, Max.
Here, Maxie. You want this? You want to sit down and play with this? It looks very dangerous.
It's not dangerous. As long as he doesn't melt it down into a knife, he'll be okay.
You know, we've been getting compliments about how we have a really high audio quality. Yeah. We sound the most professional.
I'm sorry.
It's gonna sound like a
baby screaming, and he was like pulling everything on my microphone the whole time.
Yeah, I'm sure the spring was getting picked up.
Sorry. I really didn't like this at all. I haven't read the Phasma book, but maybe if I did, I would like it a tiny bit more.
I don't know how it would add to it a whole lot.
It was awful. Like
it's like the same story. Yeah. There's just more detail and more like mythology, but Phasma does the same thing.
I thought that like there was more to Phasma. I thought that she was, you know, like you were going to get her origin story and find out what happened to her or something, like make you like her a little bit or at least understand.
Why would they want you to like her?
Because it's a really awesome. Yeah, but it's really awesome when you can get people to root for villains and you can get people to actually like them.
You don't get people to root for the person that is going to fight Finn. Like, you want people to root for Finn.
People like Kylo. People like Vader.
Because Kylo's not the bad guy.
People love Vader.
Because Vader's not the bad guy. He has a redemption.
He's pretty bad.
All right, but is he, by the end of the story, is he redeemed?
I mean, there's people that like all the bad guys. Darth Maul, people like Darth Maul. Like,
but they don't like him because they have a great backstory where they sold Boy Scout popcorn on Saturday afternoon.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying something.
It's because they do cool stuff.
Yeah, she's lame. And right. Like, there's nothing redeeming about her. And so I thought we'd...
Do you think there's anything redeeming about Maul?
Yeah.
What? What's redeeming about
Maul? Well, like, you feel
Maul?
Bad when you hear about how he was brought up.
All right, does that make it redeeming, though?
No, but that's something that can, like, make you feel something for him. Oh, my gosh. So anyway, you got nothing good from this about her. And
it just made you hate her more.
Yeah, and not even, like, she's just not even cool. She's just, like, selfish and... just a horrible, horrible person. And she's just not funny. She's not charming. She's just lame and horrible.
I've said it before.
She's efficient.
That,
what? If she could fly that TIE
fighter? They created this awesome design and then they just did nothing with her. She's uninteresting in almost every way.
Did you see how there's a gold stormtrooper in Resistance? A gold First Order stormtrooper?
No, yeah. I did not.
It looks like Phasma, but gold.
I wonder what that means.
It's a different... The name came out via a toy.
Gold
it's
is
like
gold is better than silver.
Captain Rage or something. Like it's a pretty good name.
Captain Rage?
It's not that.
If she could have flown that TIE fighter home, why didn't she just take one herself?
Well, like, she wanted to shoot the guy down.
Right. But she found out later that the
guns didn't work.
Right, because there was some BB unit.
Trying to fix it.
Oh yeah, and she even killed the BB unit.
No loose ends.
Yeah.
She was awful.
All right.
Yeah, this comic was totally useless. Even if you did like her, it didn't move the story along. It didn't do anything.
It moved it in the sense that it explained how she got out of Starkiller Bay.
Well, now,
and
but who cares?
It didn't get caught.
Right. I mean, it was kind of a thing, right? They left her for dead, and then she came back in The Last Jedi. After having aided and abetted in the destruction of the base. So they had to tie that loose end off.
Right, that's why this was Journey to the Last Jedi.
Yeah. So this comic came out before the movie. We just are reading it a year and a half after the movie. Or however long it's been. It feels like it's been a year and a half.
It's been a while. It's been a while.
I don't think it's been a year and a half, though, is it?
No.
No, it's
came out last December.
Yeah, so only about 10 months.
Oh, all right. Well, I don't know that I have that much more to talk about this comic. It was...
The art was all right.
It's okay.
It reminded me of the Obi-Wan and Anakin series.
Oh yeah, very, very much. It's, I think it's the same artist.
Is it? I believe it.
Pretty certain. I'm gonna rate it. I'm gonna give it a. I'll give it a 4.
You're not in front of a mic.
I was going to give it a 4 as well. I have to stand up behind Tim to keep this baby quiet.
Yeah, that'll last a long time.
Yeah.
I'm sure he'll be quiet for a long time.
I don't think it was that bad.
No,
it I thought it was.
I thought it was horrible.
You know, as in the trade paperback form, I would never read this in a serial comic form. I would have hated it.
Oh, yeah.
A lot
more. It would have been really irritating because you would have been plopping $4 down.
Yeah, for nothing.
Right.
Yeah. So, as a trade paperback, I'll give it a 5.
All
right. If it was in the comic form, it would have been worse than a 4.
There it is. There it is.
So, hopefully, you don't buy it at all. But if you do, buy it as a trade paperback.
What's our next episode going to be? You want to just keep doing comics?
Well, so, this Sunday... Tomorrow is the first episode of Resistance.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Already?
Already.
How do I not know?
I don't know. Because you don't pay attention to anything?
Yeah, I don't. That's correct. I pay attention to my kids and that's about it anymore.
Yeah, right.
What do you mean? I'm constantly driving kids around.
That's not paying attention. That's just being dutiful. Fulfilling duty is not the same as paying attention.
Oh, Lord. I think I do pay quite a bit of attention. More attention
true.
Than I ever have
that
in
may
my
be true.
Whole life.
Yeah. So anyways, it's like they're going to do the first 2 episodes this Sunday. So maybe we can cover that in the next episode.
Done. Sold. I was going to suggest Poe Dameron, Volume 1. All we ever did was the first issue.
Yeah.
But yeah, we've got a bunch of comics we could read.
Yeah. I think Resistance strike while the iron's hot.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. San Diego Comic-Con. Oh, this is old news. Maybe I'm thinking of New York Comic-Con.
I don't know what you're thinking of.
I am. That's what
Tim,
I'm thinking
Tim
of.
Wants to introduce some new element to the podcast where we talk about the news.
No, Josh
even
always
though
talks
we
about,
talk
you
about...
You always talk about the news. Yeah, you know, that's what it is. It's New York Comic-Con. That's why I couldn't find what I was looking for. Dummy. Yeah, I don't even know what comic book conventions are having anymore.
That's too bad. The other big news that came out in the last 2 weeks since we've recorded is they officially announced the title of the live action series. It's called The Mandalorian.
Yeah, they showed an image too.
Yeah, they showed an image and they talked about some of the directors they have lined up that are pretty promising. I think that's they've been filming episode 9 for the last month. There's lots of, I won't say any spoilers, but there's been lots of like set pictures that have gotten out and casting stuff. So like, I think we said this in the last one maybe, but Dominic Monaghan's in the movie. Pippin.
I hope he
or Mary
plays a significant role.
Based on the fact that, so he had an interview and he said that they're only filming like the first half of the film and they haven't given the second half of the film to any of the actors yet for some reason.
Yeah.
And that JJ told him that he plays a prominent role in the second half of the film. And he's been on set for like the last month and he says he's still got quite a bit to go. So
wow.
It seems like maybe similar level of role as Kelly Tran had, Rose.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking.
Yeah.
So New York Comic Con was this weekend, and they announced some new stuff. Chuck Wendig, our boy.
Oh, yes. Of,
from the Aftermath series.
Aftermath fame.
He did those Aftermath novels that none of us liked. And... he's doing a Darth Vader, Shadow of Vader 5-issue series. It's the point of view on how other characters' point of view on how Vader affected them.
Interlude.
Oh my gosh.
I hope there's interludes.
There's also going to be a new novel and I didn't see who is doing it. But it's called Alphabet Squadron.
I think that's related to Resistance in some way.
It's right after Return of the Jedi. Five pilots form a group to hunt down rogue Imperial elements.
So it's going to be out Wedge.
I hope so. Oh, they just showed some cover art for Claudia Gray's Master and Apprentice novel.
Which should be good.
Yeah, it's Obi-Wan and
Qui-Gon.
I think that was it. I thought there was another thing. Maybe it was just the Resistance trailer or something, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay. Anyway, that's exciting.
New stuff.
New stuff.
Because there won't be any, no movies until next. Oh, I guess we got Celebration in April. That's kind of a big thing.
That's coming up.
Yeah.
I got to get us somewhere to stay.
Yeah, it's 6 months away. And, you know, the city might be burned down at that point once the Bears win the Super Bowl.
Oh, they are going to win, too.
Yeah.
It's really exciting.
You don't like this, do you, Max?
He wants to play with the microphone, and he doesn't like not getting what he wants.
I wonder where he got that from.
Yeah. The vanity or the wanting to not being happy that he doesn't get what he wants.
Who's got the vanity?
I don't know. Who would have the vanity?
Both of us?
No.
What do you mean, no?
I don't think that Jen is vain.
Really?
No, I don't.
You must not know her very well
I
in
mustn't.
Her private moments.
I mustn't.
Oh my gosh.
You think I'm more vain than her?
Yeah, I do. I do think that. Let the listeners decide.
But they don't...
Hundreds of hours they've listened to you. I think they can make a pretty good estimation.
I guess.
You oh, guess. Man. I'm going to take him out of here for a while. Sorry.
Why? He's fine.
Well, he's crying. Everybody's
he's not crying.
Like,
he's just making baby
everybody's
noises.
Everybody's
going to
turn the channel when they hear this
Oh,
part.
If they haven't turned the channel already, they're not.
We doing some feedback here?
Yeah. Let's,
did you clean it up from last time?
I deleted the ones that we covered in the last
okay, good.
Episode.
But we haven't added to
I haven't it. Added to it. There's a number of emails that need to be added, but it's already like 8 pages long, so I don't think we'll have a problem.
Yeah, we'll be fine. This one's on the Rebels finale. Hey, nerds. It's from Michaela. I have some thoughts about the Rebels finale. I'm a huge Thrawn fan, and I just like what they did with... I just didn't like what they did to him. First of all, I thought it was really stupid of him to be alone with Ezra at all, seeing as how he knows Ezra is very powerful, especially since she doesn't have a Ysilamari or anything. If I were him, I would just have 50 stormtroopers in the room just in case. So, I think that does fit Thrawn, because I think he thought he had him completely figured out. He knew everything he was going to do.
Right. And he knew he wasn't going to hurt him. Like, and Ezra wasn't going to hurt Thrawn.
And the only reason Ezra got away was he did something really stupid. He did something out of character to like basically hurt them both.
I don't think it was out of character. I think it was
he
just
blew
unexpected.
Open the windows.
It was new and different.
Yeah, but he was always reckless.
But not like that.
He wasn't self-sacrificial.
Also, I really didn't like that Thrawn was taken out by stinking space whales. I mean, really?
He wasn't taken out.
I think
He's
he was
alive.
Taken out of the galaxy.
Maybe.
Into another.
Maybe.
I'm still waiting for him to show up and be the head of the First Order. I also didn't really care for Price in these eps. I like how she went down with the Empire and stuff, but she let herself be captured way too easily. Price was never impressive.
No.
Mm-mm.
She's a goon.
I get that it's a kid show, but still. I really like the rest of it and what they did with the good guys, though. I also feel like Rook was only there as to make the fans nervous. I would rate the final episodes as 8.0 and Jedi Knight as 9.7. She was trying to make us both happy there. Your fellow Star Wars nerd, Michaela. Next one is from Maria. Hello, SWNU crew. I finally worked up enough courage to write to you guys after listening to your show for about a year and a half now.
That's like four episodes.
I am subscribed to some Star Wars podcasts on Spotify, including some that are officially promoted, but nothing makes me happier than seeing that your show has been updated with a new episode.
Aww.
Which ones are officially promoted?
Like, they'll show up on the podcast banner and stuff.
Ours used to be.
Ours then was, we stopped. Ours was new, like, it wasn't officially promoted. It was just, it would show up as a high entry if you searched for Star Wars.
You didn't even have to do that. We were a top 100 podcast on Spotify.
Top 100?
Yeah.
Oh, man. We really pooped the bed.
I know. your show truly stands out from the others, and I enjoy every episode, including ones that cover mediums that I'm not as familiar with, like the comics. Well, then you'll love this one. I love listening to your reviews, commentary, theories, and banter about the Star Wars universe. You guys are great. Star Wars has always been in my life. However, I started to get really into it after seeing Episode 7. I have memories growing up of Episode 4 playing all the time. I can specifically remember watching the binary sunset scene, and I remember thinking those Ewoks in Episode 6 were so cute. I remember hearing stories of my older brothers watching Empire so many times that they literally broke the VHS tape, and I remember their expressed disappointment after seeing the special editions of the original trilogy. I wasn't all that disappointed. The only thing that was a true disappointment for me was the change of the song at the end of Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
Yum yum. Do do do.
Yeah. I don't have a strong opinion one way or another.
That should have been
it's
the
yub nub.
Whatever. Not how I remember it as a kid. When I saw trailers for The Force Awakens, I became super excited that I knew that a new era of Star Wars was returning to theaters, and that people my age would have a new set of Star Wars films that they could say when they are older, yeah, I saw that movie when I was in the theater. After I saw Episode 7, I immediately pulled out all the Star Wars DVDs I had at home and watched the entire original trilogy through twice, and then the prequel trilogy. Only once, huh?
I haven't watched the prequel trilogy in a long time.
She must not be a prequel memer.
I hope not.
I've started those a couple times recently. I always fall asleep. Star Wars puts me to sleep. It's like so relaxing for me now. I think it's the music. Or maybe I just am really lame now.
I think it's more that you're really lame.
I watched the entire Clone Wars series, and I finally got all caught up on Rebels. Whew. Us too. I have since watched the movies too many times to count, especially Episode 4, as it is my favorite Star Wars film of all time. Rogue One was the first Star Wars movie that I saw premiered where I liked to think I knew a decent amount about the Star Wars universe, and I loved it. This year, I was even more excited for The Last Jedi. When Snoke died, or did he? We have seen people survive being cut in half by a lightsaber before. You think he'll get spider legs?
No, he's gone.
I really hope not. Hashtag conspiracy. My jaw dropped to the floor. When Yoda appeared on the screen, I was trying to hold back tears. I had to see it two more times to fully appreciate it, as I was somewhat hesitant after my first viewing, but I loved it the more I watched it. Anyways, this is getting long, so keep up the great work. I hope to write to you more in the future, and I can't wait for future episodes. Well, you're going to have to. Love your show, and may the Force be with you. Maria. You want to do the next one, Josh?
Sure. Star Wars Shred. This is from...
Casey Trask. He's our Star Wars metalhead.
Yeah. He's currently touring in Europe.
Ooh.
Yeah. I don't know. Are you guys friends with him on Facebook?
Yeah.
Yeah. So he posts a lot of cool pictures.
Yeah, he does. He's like constantly...
I must not be.
...doing cool
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, you're not cool enough for that.
I guess... I didn't make the friend request.
Yeah. Hey, Tim, Jen, and Josh. It's Kate. Yeah, he says it right in the first sentence, you dummy. It's Casey from San Diego.
Himself,
yeah.
Okay.
I know I'm probably way behind, but I just heard episode 114 where you asked if I would send an MP3 to you guys. So here's the audio from one of my YouTube videos playing the Star Wars opening theme. Hope you all enjoy it. I'm still listening, trying to catch up to current episodes. I've just been super busy lately. Still love hearing you guys jabber on. It's hilarious. Keep up the good work. If anyone would like to find me on Instagram, he is at the Sentinel Trask on YouTube. And just Casey, if you can find my channel. Oh, search for Casey Trask.
On YouTube?
On YouTube. Facebook is cool, too. If you want to stay up to date on all my shows. I really appreciate you guys sharing the first video I sent you guys. It was such a surprise, and thank you again. Take care. P.S. The Last Jedi rules. Can't wait for Solo. Emoji, hands in the air.
No,
I can't remember what that's called.
The metal symbol.
The metal symbol, okay. I can't do it.
Yeah, because you got kinky,
I can only
pinky.
Do a...
Can you do it with your other hand?
My non-metal. Yeah, I can do it with the other one. It's so for the people not in the U.S., maybe, it's the symbol that you take your ring finger and middle finger and you curl them down like you're making a fist, but you leave your index finger and your pinky finger straight, and then you put your thumb over the top, and it looks kind of like...
Bunny ears.
Bunny ears, or like a horn, a longhorn cow, which you wouldn't know what that is either. So anyways, yeah. It might have a lot of high-end frequencies, so if you have a compressor or anything, that might help. Thank you. We'll have to... maybe Tim can do some stuff, and you can listen to what he sent us.
Yeah, actually, I could. Yeah. I'll stick it on the end of the episode.
There you go. This is a long one from Ben.
Going back to the metal hands, do you guys ever do metal handshakes?
No.
No.
That's where you do the inverse of the...
Yeah, nobody does that.
And you do the inverse of it, and then you both yell,
"That looks
metal!" Yeah, that's not a thing.
That's not a thing. Are you serious? Yeah. You actually did that with
people?
Yeah,
I used to do it all the time in high school. It was awesome.
I can imagine.
That looks kind of gross. And weirdly intimate.
It was.
Yeah.
It was. I was very intimate with my metal friends.
Dear SWNU crew, still loving the baby noises. Well, now they're... even louder baby noises.
Oh my gosh, so loud.
I love the last episodes, the last four episodes of Rebels. Something about the art, lighting, and music was heightened on them. I can't put my finger on it. Maybe I was just more focused. I think they put more resources into it. It really felt,
yeah,
they upped the production.
Seemed a lot different.
The last episode, my heart was racing. Never had that edge of my seat. Never had that on the edge of my seat feeling until that episode. I rate them 9, 9, 9, and 10. Only other time I gave a 10 was the last 5 minutes of the episode with Ben and Maul battling it out. Yeah, that was a good 5 minutes. I loved the wolves, but wish they were not so similar to Earth wolves. They are the same except for size and force ability and weird nostrils. That's me addenduming that in.
What's an Earth wolf?
On our planet.
Real wolf.
Oh, okay. I was like, oh, that must be some fantasy thing.
No.
You're like an Earth man.
Yeah. Like the Avatar horses had 6 legs.
See?
Has there been another animal on Star Wars other than humans that were similar to an Earth creature? Maybe the owl. Yeah, I mean, there's lots of creatures that are similar to Earth creatures. Like a Kadu is similar to an ostrich. A Ronto is similar to like a giraffe combined with a dinosaur. The Banthas are like, what are those called? The extinct...
Buffaloes?
No, they're not buffaloes. They're, I can't think of the name.
Rhino?
Woolly mammoths.
Woolly mammoths. Thank you. Mammoths. So, I mean, there's lots of things where, you know, put some hair on it and now it's a space creature. Stuff in Star Wars. The in-between world was pretty cool, but it doesn't seem to fit in the Star Wars universe. Portals and time travel is more of a Star Trek thing, but it doesn't bother me as long as they don't do it again. And Ahsoka has been saved. Ahsoka the White now, right? So that's a cultural reference. Let's see if Jen understands the cultural reference.
Her lightsaber color?
No, let me say it again. Ahsoka the White.
Ahsoka the
White. She doesn't have it.
Is that a Lord of the Rings thing?
Yes!
Fly, you fools!
Yeah. Okay.
What's the reference, though?
The tall wizard guy. When he came back, he was the white.
The tall wizard guy, the white.
Yep.
Gandalf.
Yeah, Gandalf.
He was Gandalf the Grey.
Right.
Yeah.
And then he was reborn as Gandalf the White.
Yeah.
It was weird to me when he didn't have all of his memories.
Yeah. He had faint, not full memories, but he knew things that had occurred.
It was like all of the things that had happened to him recently had happened to him 150 years or 200 years before.
I think it was more that it hadn't happened to him. It had happened to Gandalf the Grey.
Right.
And they were not the same.
But
he knew that people would remember him as Gandalf. It felt like it was a new being that was like, yeah, you'll probably think I'm Gandalf, and I know what happened to him, but that's not me. But I'll just sort of act like it was.
But it was him.
Sort of. I don't know. This isn't a Lord of the Rings podcast.
It was really strange. I'm sure somebody's written some sort of
I'm sure.
Doctoral thesis on that.
Yeah. In one of the episodes, did you notice the spin move the ghost did to knock that Imperial ship into the mountain? Just like in the Solo trailer.
Just like every time I ever flew a spaceship.
Yeah, which will probably be deleted from Solo. It wasn't. It made it to the final cut. Was Pig Guy Hondo's sidekick? He's not just a pig guy. He's an Ugnaught. You remember the Ugnaughts from Bespin? A little overly dramatic when he was shot. Yeah, that was that was like the whole point. That he was trying to get out of work. He was shot right in the chest, but then was perfectly fine moments later. Not enough rebels died in this ending. They couldn't even get rid of the pig.
Yeah, that was stupid. Like,
would it have been better to let Piggy die? And then later everyone is eating bacon? No. I loved his sidekick. I can't remember his name right now.
I like him too.
Melch?
Was something Melch? Like that, yeah.
Yeah, that does sound right.
Yeah, I loved that guy. Maybe the coolest use of the Force Ezra has ever had when the back and forth between Thrawn and troopers behind him. Super intense. It was very similar to Kanan's use of the Force at his ending. It seemed very appropriate. Ben. Here's one from Maddie. Hello, Jen, Tim, and Josh. I would have written sooner, but I didn't want to add to the mountain of letters y'all are buried under. So I figured I'd wait until at least some letters were read. Some letters she sent were read, not just any letters. Her backlog, her back catalog. Also, I was late on finishing Rebels, about a month late, so I wanted to finish that too. I was also told that Hera got a kid because another friend spoiled it for me. This is two different friends. I think I need new friends that won't spoil stuff. I don't know. Hera having a kid's not that really big of a spoiler.
I think it's crazy that she has multiple friends that watch Rebels.
I don't know. I think the young kids watch the Rebels.
She's in high school. She's not that young. Yeah. High schoolers. I don't know any high schoolers that watch Rebels.
I don't know.
We live with a lot of high schoolers.
I bet that one kid that
went to the Star Wars read day.
Yeah,
he definitely does.
He's a senior this year. He's a linebacker, and he crushes fools.
Yeah,
and he's also a really nice kid.
His dad's the coach.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He gives me hope for society.
Hey, mama.
Can I just apologize for how stupid every prediction I've ever made sounds in hindsight? That's everyone's prediction ever.
I'd like to remind the audience yet again of Josh's prediction that Finn is Lando and Leia's child.
It would have been a better story.
Oh, I forgot about that.
I make some stupid remarks sometimes. It's gonna happen. I'm 14. It's not just 14-year-olds. All adults make horrible predictions. I hope you have a blast in Disney World. This couldn't have been a letter pre-Disney World.
Wow.
Hopefully she's saying in the past tense. I hope. I've been 7 times and love it. Be sure to... No, this was pre-Disney World. Be sure to spend at least 2 days at Magic Kingdom and 2 days in Epcot. The myth is that Epcot stands for Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow, but it really stands for Every Person Comes Out Tired. My all-time favorite rides are the Rock and Roller Coaster, Expedition Everest, Tower of Terror, Test Track, Soarin', and It's a Small World. It's a Small World is the worst ride at Disney.
Yeah.
By a country mile.
I went again, and it didn't... My memory did not hold up of it, and I did not like it that much.
It's the worst. I'm a Disney encyclopedia, so contact this dis nerd for anything. When Calls the Heart is on Hallmark Channel, she meant to say something else.
When Calls the Heart is the title.
Yes,
it?
Okay. It's a made for, so those not in the U.S. The Hallmark Channel is a made-for-TV movie channel, basically.
Yeah.
It is based on the books by Jeanette Oakey. I don't know. O-K-E. It's a weird spelling. I'm sorry, Jen, but A Wrinkle in Time is the second worst book I've ever read, only passed by The Old Man and the Sea.
Oof.
You could review Forces of Destiny, and that would be all great and wonderful. I would really like that, actually. But you could also review and discuss my favorite Star Wars movie, Return of the Jedi. Everything on Tatooine is my favorite part, especially the sandpit scene. Or even some novels. Will the two next Star Wars shows air on Disney or just the Disney Netflix thing? Any idea at all? May the Force be with you, Maddie. So we know Resistance will air on Disney XD or the Disney Now app. The live-action show will almost certainly be on the streaming service, I'd have to imagine.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird,
they've
though.
Already announced that.
It's kind of weird because they can't do the streaming service, and or they're not doing it until the end of 2019 when all their Netflix agreements come up. So it just feels like a really long time to wait a year and a half for a TV show, but whatever.
Are they really not launching it till then? I thought they were just not going to have everything on there until then.
I don't know.
I'll have to look that up. That was from Maddie. You already said that, right?
Yeah.
How many more letters do you want to do?
I don't know. We could. Jen's not in the room. Neither is Max.
You could tell by
the quietness. The pristine audio quality has been restored.
This one's from Amber. Have we had, like, except for Ben, we've had like 6 emails in a row from female fans.
Yeah.
It's awesome. Hello there. Hope this email finds you all well. I'm just wondering if you guys have checked out all the bonus content on the new The Last Jedi DVD. Tim, I know you said you got digital, but I wasn't sure what all that included.
It had all the bonus content that came with the physical release.
I watched all the deleted scenes, and I watched the commentary on the deleted scenes.
I watched the documentary, and that's it.
I watched the documentary, too.
And I watched the commentary on the full film, the Rian Johnson commentary. But I didn't watch any of the deleted scenes.
I started the Rian Johnson commentary, but I did not finish it. My friend and I stayed late at work the other day and watched the director and the Jedi. And
oh my God,
was it amazing.
That's the documentary.
I really do have a deeper appreciation for all the sheer manpower that goes into making these films. I felt the intimacy Ryan allowed with his process for the film really made me less critical of some of the small stuff and also answered many questions I was still having with the film. I don't want to give much away, but there's a bit about Mark and Carrie shooting their scene on Crait, and it was super weird because someone started cutting onions right near my corneas at the same time. That's an odd coincidence.
Weird, yeah.
I was super happy with all the bonus stuff and blew through most a couple times the day it was released. This was especially satisfying since The Force Awakens was so underwhelming on its DVD content. Even though I am partial to The Last Jedi, I really do like Ryan more than JJ, just in the sense that I feel he loves and understands Star Wars infinitely more and took bigger risks than JJ's 7 for sure. Will y'all be doing an ep on any of the bonus content? I think we discussed it.
Yeah, I think we
in one of the episodes
roughly discussed it.
a couple weeks ago was South by Southwest here in Austin. And guess who came? Mark and Ryan did. A full interview and strolled downtown Austin the Tuesday of that week. And if you think I missed the Mark Hamill and the latest director, then you are absolutely right, because I am poor and I was working not 2 miles away. Ugh. I love Austin. Have you ever been there?
Nope.
You'd hate it, but I liked it.
Yeah.
It's a cool, really cool area downtown. It's unique. I've never been anywhere like it. Anyway, do you guys have any plans for May the 4th? I'm thinking about getting a Star Wars tattoo, but not sure yet. Did you? I need a Star Wars tattoo.
I would discourage you to get a tattoo.
I keep thinking about getting a Star Wars Nerds Unite logo tattoo.
I don't think that you should.
I really like the colors on it.
They're cool colors. I just don't.
Jesus outdid himself.
I would just generally recommend anti-tattoo.
I know. I know. That's how they control my mind.
Yeah, it is. The nanobots.
Right. I'm so ready for you guys to get back into books and comics, though. Those are definitely my favorite episodes. Well, you're welcome. Reading Dark Disciple now, and it's excellent. I'm trying to get pumped for Han Solo, but it's being absolutely eclipsed by Infinity Wars right now. Well, I want to keep this short, since I know fan feedback takes up a lot of your time. Hope baby Max is growing into the perfect youngling. May the Force be with y'all, Amber. this one's from Randall. Hey, nerd leaders. I apologize for the recent lack of emails. School's getting too busy. Recently, my birthday passed, and my mom got me the book Star Wars Lost Stars, and it's so good. I've only gotten in halfway, and I already love the characters, from Sienna's loyalty to Thrain's determination. I love a good underdog story. Me too. Hashtag Science Corner. Why is it when you breathe in helium, your voice gets higher, and when you breathe in sulfur hexafluoride, makes your voice deeper?
It has to do with the density of the gas, I believe. Because your vocal cords work by vibrating, but the pitch of the vibration is influenced by traveling through the medium that it's going through, because it's a wave. So I'm pretty sure it has to do with the density of the air passing over your vocal cords.
There you have it. Hashtag fun fact. Did y'all know that the villains of the prequels, Darth Maul, Count Dooku, and General Grievous, directly matched Darth Vader's story? Maul was a Sith. Ooh, did you?
Sorry, I was.
That's okay.
Cleaning up.
Maul was a Sith consumed by hatred. Count Dooku was a fallen Jedi, and Grievous was a cyborg. Darth Daddy was all three of these. He was a fallen Jedi who was consumed by hatred and turned cyborg. Anyway, sorry for the lack of emails lately. P.S. Chance of new Nerd Squadron induction on episode 150. Hint, hint. Thanks for being so awesome, and may the mass times acceleration be with you. Happy Good Friday, Easter Sunday, Randall. Nerd Squadron stuff. We haven't talked about that in a while.
Yeah. Missed the 150. By a few.
Yeah.
He didn't.
I considered it. You said it was up to me, and then, of course, did not happen.
It's up to you and Jen. It's not. I'm not involved. I have removed myself from the entire process.
Yeah, it's hard to get Jen to do stuff for the podcast, though. She likes to just blame me that things don't happen, but she also does not do things. I'm glad she's not here to kick me under the table. This one's from James. He says, "Hi, gang." That makes me think of It's Always Sunny.
Yeah.
Have you watched
this season? No, we're a few seasons behind.
Oh my gosh. Episode 4 of this season is the funniest episode that I've ever seen.
It's better than like Rum Ham and yes. Chardy Dennis. Chardy McDennis.
This one tickled my funny bone in all the right places.
Dayman.
Inspired by your episodes reading out letters, I thought I would send something along here on Easter weekend. So it's April, right? We're back in April?
Yeah.
That's not too far.
I mean, it's 6 months ago.
Yikes. And be excited to hear you read it at some point in the summer.
Close. Snuck it in right after it turned into fall.
In all seriousness, though, I wanted to say thanks for your podcast. Oh, he was joking about it being all the way till the summer.
Yeah.
But in fact, we gave him fall, making it even funnier.
Yeah.
I'd previously listened to two podcasts back in 2010 or something, but never really got into it. Then back in the summer of 2015, after having had a big fight with my wife about a laminator. Don't we all have big fights about laminators?
I wish I had a laminator to fight over.
I decided to take my in-laws' dogs for a long walk and listen to something. Hey, why not a Star Wars podcast? So I downloaded Podcast Addict and found your review of Aftermath, which I had just completed myself. I enjoyed your style. I loved that Jen had never really been into Star Wars and just generally liked your discussions. I listened to a bunch more, then looked for other podcasts and would listen to them on my commute. I'm going to add in that he hated those. And only
they were
liked
all
ours.
Garbage.
Unfortunately, my car changed and I had nowhere to listen to podcasts for about a year until January, just gone. Man, have I had some catching up to do. But I am enjoying it. Now I just need to binge season 4 of Rebels so I can listen to your discussions on that. Keep being awesome and congratulations on Maximus. I like to imagine that if my wife liked Star Wars, we would also have a podcast in our attic. But she doesn't, so we don't.
Send us a link if you ever do.
Yeah, for real.
You need to find a third wheel. And then you can have a podcast in your attic.
You'll never find one as cool and as famous as Josh.
No. No, you won't.
Do you want to do the one from Drew?
Sure. It's entitled Shirt! Exclamation point. I received my shirt. Just wanted to say thank you. It was pretty sweet, but anytime I wear it, I can feel my chances of meeting women reduce. He's married, by the way. So his
hopefully his wife doesn't hear
his
this.
More crude reference that he provided is untrue. That being said, I still wear it. The other day, The Force Awakens was on network TV, so I started watching it. When I put it on, I asked if I would like to start from the beginning. Yes, please. I have to admit, I don't think I've watched this movie but one or two times at most. So I noticed something, and now I see it in Rebels as well. What's with the stormtroopers with red or white shoulder pads? They're like officers. That's their method of showing rank, basically.
Wouldn't that allow them to, like, shoot a bigger gun? Isn't that what those are for?
What?
Shoulder pad.
No.
Why not?
Because that's not what they're for. They're just to denote rank.
Okay.
The other thing that cracked me up, in the scene where Kylo is extracting the location of the map from Poe, he starts using the Force to look into his mind. My dog, who was sleeping on the floor, jumped up and started growling at the TV. I thought it was funny. He was being tortured along with Poe. After that, the movie glitched and restarted from the beginning without the ability to fast forward, and I couldn't handle watching it again, as this had happened two times already, and I just gave up. Anyway, hope you're all doing well. Drew, P.S. Are you ever going to reveal how old John J. Best PIA is? Jen's guess was 72 or something.
I don't know how old enough to be a Brewers fan.
Yeah.
I don't know. How old does that make you?
Wisconsin? No.
Yeah.
So in other picture news from Drew, let me see if I still have it. So there's another person that off and on listens. Like, he only listens when he mows. So he's at like episode 68 or something.
Yeah.
And
you're talking about Chad?
Yeah. So Drew was back in town and was visiting with Chad, or Chad was down there. I can't remember the course of events that this occurred. But Chad's wife had bought one of our shirts off of wherever we sell our shirts from. I can't remember.
We have a link on the website.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. And so Chad had never told me, because he doesn't like to pay compliments to me in person.
It's because he knows it empowers you. Any compliment just makes you stronger.
And so Drew sneakily sent me a picture of him and Chad wearing their shirts together.
That's cute.
Their SWNU shirts
That's
together.
That's really cute.
And I was hoping I still had it on my phone, but
we've sold quite a few shirts.
Yeah.
I was surprised.
He's made some cool designs.
Yeah, he did. It's one of those t-shirt places emailed me, like, personally on my personal email.
Oh yeah.
And told me how great our podcast is and how they want to print our shirts, and I ignored them.
Well, we're doing a lot for our marketing this week.
Well, we're not super good at marketing ourselves.
Yeah, whatever.
It doesn't help that we don't put out episodes anymore.
I did sign us up to maybe podcast on the stage at Celebration. There was a whole form I had to fill out.
I remember.
And I took submissions from people on what the best episodes were, because you had to submit 3 episodes.
I hope they tell us no.
I set it all up. Why? What are you afraid of if they say yes?
I'd be afraid of getting in front of all those people and having
a podcast. There won't be anybody there other than the few people from that listen.
No, dude.
It's not like...
Yes, it is.
No, it's
Have
not
you ever
like
been
you
to
think.
Those stages? Yes, it is. There's 100 and some odd people in the room.
Oh, 100 people? That's nothing.
What are we going to talk about?
Star Wars.
Everybody in that room knows more than me.
So what?
I feel like a
We're not here to provide authority. We're here to provide smooth talking and...
Smooth talking. Conversation.
Good noises and ear sounds.
All right.
Yeah. We're not there to show off our knowledge.
This one is from Maddie. Questions Disney and Disney questions. Jen, has leaving Max at daycare gotten any easier? I think we answered that on the last episode.
Yeah, you gave up on daycare.
Yeah, daycare could not continue to have. Although now, he would love daycare. He would be...
Most kids do.
He would be crazy happy about it. It was so expensive. It was killing me.
Daycare is expensive.
Also, you missed Small World.
You guys did. I didn't.
I didn't. The next time I went.
Oh, your first, our trip, our combined trip, you guys did not go to Small World.
Right, but then I had to go again later with Nora.
Right.
And I got to sneak into Magic Kingdom.
Yeah, sneak.
Well, I mean, I didn't have to pay to get into Magic Kingdom.
Sure, that's not really sneaking.
Is it not?
No. Sneaking is like you pulled one over on them. It's just you were part of a group that caused you to not have to pay.
Yeah.
That's not sneaking.
Is it not?
They were compensated in some fashion.
Am I thinking of the wrong trip? I think I'm mixing the two trips up.
I have no idea.
Whatever. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't.
I didn't miss It's a Small World.
But Jen
did.
Still has not seen it.
Josh, what's a subreddit? Subreddit? Subreddit?
It's subreddit. The second one that you sent. So Reddit is a website.
R-E-D-D-I-T .com.
And there are, it's segmented up. It's broken up basically into categories. And anyone can make a category for anything as long as somebody hasn't already taken it. And those categories are called subreddits. So generally it'll be reddit.com/r/ whatever something. The subreddit is.
Yeah, and you can, a lot of times you can just type a thing after r. And
right.
It's already been done.
So like for Apple products, /r/Apple.
Right.
Android's the same way. I mean, the NFL, anything that's big enough that you would think about searching the internet for it probably has a subreddit.
Yeah. And you can just Google like Chicago Bears subreddit and it comes up.
Right.
And you'll get to see hilarious memes.
And so it's a way to, it's, if you know what like forums are, it's kind of like a weird version of a forum. But it's just more focused being a subreddit. It's not, when you go to Reddit, it's just like the smorgasbord. There's a bunch of subs that can filter up into the front page. So you might get lots of random stuff. But if you just are really interested in Lego, then go to /r/Lego. There's a whole subreddit for it. So that's what that is.
Reddit was, I think I saw like a news article pop up that it was the 4th most visited website now.
I'd believe it.
Isn't that crazy?
No.
Even like 6 years ago, it was not that popular. I mean, it was popular with like super nerds.
Yeah, there aren't many places, any aggregators anymore. Like all the big ones, like Fark. Does Fark even exist anymore?
Yeah, it does.
I mean.
Yeah, it does.
That was a pretty big aggregator.
Yeah, it was.
But that was more curated than
Reddit. Absolutely was curated. Yeah.
So that's the other thing about Reddit is there's a whole algorithm, but the algorithm is based on upvotes. The amount of people, humans, clicking on an up arrow next to the article.
Right.
For a certain period of time. So if you get lots of upvotes in a quick period of time, it'll filter up to the top. So it's basically like, this is what people are interested in right now.
Right.
All right. Back to the... Are you reading or am I reading?
I am. Also, is Ron Howard the director of Solo, the same Ron Howard who played Opie Taylor on The Andy Griffith Show and Richie Cunningham on Happy Days? Yes. Yes.
He's also directed like a billion movies.
Apollo 13?
Yeah.
And he's...
the voice of the narrator on Arrested Development.
Also, I started my last soccer game. It was the first time. We have two more games. Our current win-loss ratio is 6-6?
6 wins, 6 losses, I assume.
In case you were interested. Can you do another feedback episode? I think we need it. I think this is turning into one. Also, it's some of my favorite podcasts. I'm all for podcast marathon weekend. You could also review Return of the Jedi or Forces of Destiny.
That's the second email in a row where she suggested Return of the Jedi, and I still don't think Jen's watched it.
I think I heard something about a cow in a Walmart in Peru, Illinois recently. Did that actually happen, or did I hear something incorrectly? Based on what I know of Peru, Illinois...
I believe it.
Yes. Yes, there was a cow there. I live in what I call a Disney family, so we love the parks. We also love how nice the cast members are. We live 10 hours from Disney World, and we never fly because my dad hates not being in control of the vehicle and is claustrophobic. Can understand that.
Weird thing about claustrophobia is your car is a smaller space.
Yeah, but it's a control thing.
The control thing I get, but the claustrophobia I don't.
When you feel in control, you don't feel claustrophobic.
Maybe.
I have not been since Pandora, but want to. You should go. Pandora is amazing. Did your kids pin trade or get autographs from the characters?
No.
Not this time around, no. They did when they were younger. It was fun. But I didn't want to, like, deal with it.
Yeah, it's a thing.
I always try to when I go. It is really fun. What was y'all's favorite rides?
I didn't really ride a whole lot of rides. The only one I got to ride was when we rode the mine
together. That was pretty fun. I liked the, we've already talked about it a million times, but the Pandora ride was the best one.
So I had been previously, and Everest is really good. That's probably my favorite ride at Disney.
I can't do Everest. That makes me so sick. Going backward like that.
Yeah.
Smoke me. I always try... Blah, blah, blah. Is the Indiana Jones stunt show spectacular with Harrison Ford's stunt double still open? Yes. It's like one of three things still open.
It's not actually his stunt double. It's just a guy. It's entertaining.
Yeah. Once you've seen it like 10 times,
yeah,
though,
I mean,
it's not as good anymore.
Yeah.
That is a personal favorite of mine. Mine too. Star Tours is awesome too. I've never been the Rebel spy, but I want to. Paige was the spy. Have you seen Orange Bird in Sunshine Tree Terrace? He's so cute. So I saw Orange Bird on, in Downtown Disney or whatever, the Disney Springs. And there's like this fancy clothing store, cool clothes. And there was this dress with Orange Bird
on it.
And I don't know.
Like an Orange Bird print?
Yeah. But I have no clue who that is Sunshine Tree Terrace is.
Yeah, I had no clue what this was until she sent the email. I put the picture in there.
Yeah, I see it, but I still... Created for the Magic Kingdom Park in 1971, the Orange Bird has returned home to the Sunshine Tree Terrace. Where is that?
I don't know.
We like to stay at Pop Century Resort on Disney property. Epcot is my dad's favorite park. He loves it. In Epcot, we eat at the American Adventure and watch the show. Where's that?
I don't know.
There's a show?
I mean, American Adventure is on the other side of the lake.
I know where that is. I didn't know there was a show there.
I don't know either.
I've seen, like, there's one for Canada and, what was that redheaded guy? Martin Short? He does the...
Martin Short?
Yeah.
Redheaded?
Yeah. I mean, he was redheaded when he was younger.
Really?
Yeah, before he went gray.
What?
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever seen Martin Short with red hair.
Okay. Maybe I'm overreading it in my head, but I was pretty sure he did have it. You shouldn't have missed it. We also eat in the place next to Soren that's not the fancy one. Make any sense?
It would have made more sense a while ago.
Yeah.
But
well, now I want to go back to Disney World. Signing off, Maddie.
Does Martin Short, has he ever had red hair? Jen just walked in the room. Yeah, she said no. This is Martin Short.
It's brown.
It's always been brown.
Right. Good. Perfect.
So who is, if you were to say that Canadian guy with red hair, who would you think of? Who is the narrator of the Canada show at Epcot?
All right.
I'm a dummy. Well, we all know. Good
wait,
work.
Is Martin Short Canadian?
I would believe it.
Yeah. This one's from Randall.
What? I'm going to find out who the narrator is at the Canada show at Epcot. Is it a 360 movie?
Oh, I've never seen that.
Is it called O Canada?
Yeah.
360 movie?
Yeah.
It is narrated by Martin Short.
I knew it was narrated by Martin Short.
He even has not red hair in the picture on the old-timey.
It looks red to me.
Only because his head is highlighted by a red square.
Still looks red.
But don't you know him? He's in a million things.
Yeah, and I've always thought of him as having red hair.
He doesn't even have red hair.
Red hair, but it's...
It's brown.
It's brown.
It's like kind of dark
good.
Brown.
Good. I'm so glad you made it back.
Sorry.
She's just helping clarify.
Saw The Last Jedi at home in 4K today. This is from Randall. After only seeing it in theaters, and I loved it so much. Thought you guys get a kick out of reading this if you haven't already. Also, my second son... What? This isn't from Randall.
No, it's not from Randall.
Oh, it's from Jesse. We just didn't put his name in there somehow. Also, my second son was born a few days ago. Micah has a new little brother. His name is Roman. Did it again. Ellis. I'll send pictures. Hope all three of you are doing well.
He sent a picture.
He sent a very cute picture.
And the thing he was talking about, the cool comic book snippet I included the link to.
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember the context as it was months ago.
Oh, yeah. It shows just a comic of them sitting around the table.
Oh, on the Falcon after The Last Jedi?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's in Poe Dameron number 26. So we'll get to it someday.
Someday. This is from Randall. What's up, nerd leaders? To begin, I'd like to say that I did not appreciate the small imminent divorce joke in the synopsis of episode 147 of SWNU. You guys are one of my main sources of laughter, and if something like that would happen, I would drop dead like a Dagobah dragon snake, if that's still canon. I was so tensed up until the joke came along where I realized it was a joke. Messed me up. There was such a long pause and I tensed up so much.
Oh no.
Were we kidding?
Oh my god, you just did it.
It was entirely you.
It's always you.
It's always you.
I think that you tried to say something about divorcing me and then I just didn't respond.
I'm sure if we had our cameras set up, it would have been a great moment where I was rolling my eyes.
Hashtag science corner. Yeah, not even paying attention to me. What is electricity? Like, what makes electricity? It's so cool, but so dangerous. And why is it that it is so dangerous? So much so that it could kill you. How does it stop your heart? Holy cow, that's a lot of questions. Go ahead.
All right. Electricity is the transmission of electrons through a media. But it doesn't, like, the electron doesn't, like, it's not like a ball that you roll through a pipe. It's more, if you had 100 people and each person was holding two apples, but the one on the end didn't have an apple, and somebody walked up and handed them an apple, and they all just passed an apple to the left, and then on the other end, an apple popped out. That's a really weird analogy. The electron basically jumps into a molecule, and that molecule gives up an electron at the same time.
Okay.
So it's like...
It's passing energy.
It's a wave of transmission of electrons from one molecule to the next.
A flow.
It's not a flow, though. We represent it as flow. Current is represented as flow, but at the lowest level, that's not what it is. Because it's not one electron that starts at the beginning and ends at the end. It's one electron that gets given to one molecule, and then that molecule gives a different electron to a different molecule, and that one gives a different electron. So it's just each one passes left once, basically. And that's how you get an electron coming in and an electron going out. So electricity is that interaction occurring a lot over time. And it is encouraged by this thing called potential, which is, we call it voltage. So voltage is what pushes and forces these molecules to do this electron transfer. And the amount of energy that it takes. So depending on what the molecule is, it has different electrical properties. And it gives off this little electric field. And this, the electron resists traveling through this electric field to transfer to the next molecule. And so the amount of the size of the electrical field is proportional to the resistance of that electron transferring over. And that's how we get this thing called resistance. It is, at its core, it is basically the size of the electric field that the molecule puts off. And so it resists flow. And so if you have a higher resistance, you need more energy, current. We represent that as current, in order to have the electron flow occur. So that's what electricity is at a high level, even though that was incredibly detailed. And you probably don't, it probably didn't help you. But why is it dangerous, you ask? So our hearts beat on a rhythm. Like if you ever see a TV show or they show the EKG.
I can explain this.
Do it.
Your heart is a muscle, and it, the mechanism that makes it contract or pump is electrical impulses traveling down a specific route through your heart, through the different chambers. And if you get shocked, it interrupts that impulse.
It can make the muscle basically, because there are four chambers, and the pump, it only pumps if certain valves are closed when the muscles contract. Otherwise, it won't pump in the right direction, or it won't do anything. It'll just compress the blood. So it makes one of the muscles misfire and gets everything out of whack.
It starts in your atrium, and it, when your atrium contracts and then it travels down, it starts at this spot called your sinus node, and then it goes, the pulse, the electrical current travels down to your lower chambers of your heart and the ventricles, and goes through different spots, and like there's this bundle of all this like fibers, and then it goes down to the very bottom. And if your electrical impulse doesn't go through the right path and it's just interrupted, then it doesn't cause that strong pump for your blood, and it can make your heart just kind of like quiver and
right, it gets out of rhythm.
It's just a mess.
And then so it'll continue beating.
And then you have
beating.
To shock it again.
Well, you in certain cases you attempt to shock it again to get it back into rhythm.
Mm-hmm.
But it'll continue to beat. It just won't be effectively pumping blood. So like the muscle just doesn't go, oh, you shocked me, I give up. It continues to try to pump, but it's out of rhythm, so it can't pump. And so you don't get blood flow, so your cells don't get oxygen, and so they start dying.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was like 20 minutes.
Well, and we barely even scratched the surface on electricity.
Have you thought about being a science teacher?
Well, no.
I can see you making these little kids stand up and like pass the apple.
Yeah.
On the topic of science, what are the results of the Dagobah garlic swamp water experiments?
There are no results. We didn't.
Does it still taste like garlic?
I won't taste it anymore.
Absolutely it right. does.
So then the experiment showed that there's still some mystery causing garlic smell.
It, I mean, nothing fixed the problem.
Yeah, we just nothing don't use ice away. Anymore.
There's no...
We have to buy ice.
They buy
like
bags of ice and dump
station.
It in their sink.
Just moving at parties. Just moving at parties.
They installed an extra sink just for ice.
Just for ice. Instead of fixing our water issue.
Yeah.
I really wish that water issue was fixed. But you know what? Like, there's several people that I know of that, like, when I go to their house, I could
they
tell
have the
they
same
have
problem.
The same problem, but they're not aware. I want
to
be like,
they're used to it.
Do you know that your ice is disgusting?
Your ice
because
is
because you just
Jacob
gave me a
water.
Cup of ice. Like,
it's because you get used to it. And plus, if it's cold enough,
I
your taste buds don't
work. To get used to it.
Yeah, so this does not follow that rule because it's so terrible. It's such a bad taste. We have not gotten any results back, and you know what they say. Curiosity kills the loath cat, maybe even the attic feral cat.
Oh, my God.
Request for Mr. Mason to please answer in your mod, the water bill lady. Mod. The water
Maud,
bill lady
yeah.
voice, please.
So the way Maud is spelled, Randall, for future reference, is M-A-U-D-E. But we get it. I don't...
He wanted you to answer the science corner question.
There's no way I was going to answer the science corner
that
question.
That would be really hard.
Probably the results of the garlic swamp water experiment. But yeah. I didn't... So we made ice, right? I brought water over from my house.
Yeah.
Made ice in your fridge. It's there somewhere.
What did you put it in a Star Wars little thing?
Yeah. I think I brought the Death Star.
Maybe we should get check and see if that was used.
I guarantee you it tastes like garlic.
Well
that
we
was
can
the
try
experiment.
It. That we should try it right as soon as we're done. I'll put some in a cup and drink it.
All right.
And then I'll throw up.
It's
back
the
in.
Death Star ball, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I thought I brought the Death Star ball over.
All right, we'll try it.
With my water.
Fun fact, kinda. Oh, do you want to read this as Maud?
No.
Do you even remember the voice?
I can't do voices on command.
Oh, okay.
It has to be a moment of inspiration.
Organic.
A moment of inspiration. Do you know what ATTE, AT-AT, and ATM-6 mean? It stands for All-Terrain Tactical Enforcer, All-Terrain Armored Transport, and All-Terrain Mega Caliber 6. Pretty sure you all knew that, but I thought no harm to bring it up. I didn't know what the M6 was.
I only knew that because I have Lego.
I realized something about...
I don't understand how they say that you're supposed to call an AT-AT.
Nobody says you're supposed to call it that.
I read an article that said that's the right way to do it.
They're wrong.
They're wrong.
That article was incorrect.
Whatever. But how can you do the other ones? How can you say the other ones without the letters? It doesn't...
That's the whole point why they're wrong.
Hmm.
You say it however you want.
Right.
I realized something about flirting in Star Wars.
Oh, I know. I saw a commercial from when, like, the 70s with the toys, and they called it an AT-AT in the commercial.
Yeah, colloquially, people call them AT-ATs. That doesn't make it their formal name or what you're supposed to call it.
Okay.
Are you an angel? Who are you? Someone who loves you. You are nothing. But not to me.
Are you reading your journal or is
no,
this a
this,
letter?
So he was reading.
That just was so out of nowhere.
He was reading three quotes from the three different trilogies. One quote from each.
Prequel, original, and sequel.
And he didn't do a very good job of it.
Yeah, it was all ran together.
Because, I mean, one of them is two people talking to each other, but he read it as one sentence.
Start over.
Anakin to Padme, are you an angel? This is little tiny Anakin, by the way.
I don't know what he realized about flirting. What did he realize?
I don't... Maybe he's just saying he learned about flirting.
I realized something about flirting in Star Wars, prequel trilogy. Are you an angel?
Yeah, he's saying this is... He's going to model his game off of these statements.
Okay. All right, I got it now. Anyway, thanks for being awesome and bringing me through one of the toughest parts of my life, the biggest hive of scum and villainy. a secondary school where bullies lie around every corner. Stay awesome and may the force be with you. Randall out.
I don't remember there being bullies in middle school.
He lives in Singapore.
I got picked on in middle school. I got picked on in high school.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't remember getting picked on.
I was really vain. Bullies.
You were quite vain.
So I wore...
Everyone's trying to bring you down a peg.
Everybody was trying to pull my pants down.
No.
Why?
Because I was sagging my pants a ton. I wore those giant skater pants and my butt would always hang out.
That we had bullies or that he has bullies?
No, he
had bullies.
Yeah. Well, he's in another country. We don't know what it's like.
You live in Portugal.
Said,
this podcast is a lot more boring if Jen's not here.
Tim said...
We were getting through letters. We were pumping them out.
Tim said, I don't remember any bullies in middle school, but...
I said that.
He said that.
Okay, well... Okay, whoever said it, but I'm saying it could be totally different there. It doesn't matter
what
your
men
experience
said
was.
Well, I wasn't invalidating his experience. I'm merely discussing our own.
Right.
That's what
he brought something up, and I'm relating to it with my own experience.
Jeez Louise.
How about your middle school? What did they do there? Did they pedantically correct everyone?
I don't know, but the baby is very mad.
All right. I don't think we've had audio for a long time.
Hi, baby.
Oh, no, it's working. I just...
sleep for about 10
awkward
minutes.
Cut.
Yeah, Max is back. He's screaming his head off.
We have had audio the whole time.
Yeah, we have.
Just the...
Yeah, it kind of messed up.
The recording tool was weird.
So
anyways, we'll never hear about Jen's high school. She was probably the bully.
No.
I guarantee you she was the bully.
Oh my gosh.
She bullies me all the time.
Nolan, were you bullied in middle school?
Was I bullied in middle school?
Was there a lot of bullies?
No.
Were there bullies around every corner?
I mean, there were people who made fun of other people, but I wouldn't call them bullies.
Yeah. I don't remember there being bullies in middle school.
They weren't real bullies. I mean, not the ones portrayed in the movies, at least.
Not like Nelson.
People say that they're getting bullied if somebody says something online that's like...
There's a line between, hey, you've got mustard on your shirt and, you know, your face is stupid every day for 6 months, right? One of those is a bully and one of those just a kid being a snotty kid.
People talk about online bullying all the time.
Yeah, because you can do that.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to move away from bullying right now.
Don't be a bully. Don't be a Jen.
I'm not a bully.
All right, I'm gonna do one more letter and then we'll call it quits because Max's ready to not have his mom taking up recording.
He's yawning a lot. You should just put him in bed.
He was asleep. He just woke up.
Oh my gosh! People are insane,
dude.
He's been going to bed a lot earlier, like 11. Nolan, he wants you to come back.
This is from Maddie. 20 days to go till solo.
This is the third Maddie email
in
this episode.
This episode, yeah.
That's how far back we are.
Greetings to Jen, Tim, and Josh from a finally warm Alabama. I thought this winter would never end. Now I just have to survive the pollen. Can't wait to see Solo. Only 20 days to go. I hope I can see it opening week. That way, my well-meaning friends can't spoil anything. How is/was Free Comic Book Day?
I didn't engage in Free Comic Book Day this year.
I did. I went to Zeke's and bought...
How was it?
It was good. I saw Jeremiah Lambert art.
Yeah.
And talked to Zeke for a while and bought a comic book and then caught a few others. I got the Simpsons comic, which I always get, the Free Comic Book Day version. You never reviewed Forces of Destiny.
Yeah. Still haven't.
Just saying, I haven't seen the new episodes either. Also, would you please review Return of the Jedi for episode 150?
Oh.
Man, I suggested that and Jen wouldn't
watch. Jen's like, I have to watch a movie?
For your favorite 14-year-old fan from Alabama, actually, I'll probably be 15 by the time this makes the air. My birthday is in a few days. Any chance I can be added to Nerd Squadron for my 15th birthday?
Yeah, she might be 16.
Thanks for never failing to make me laugh. May the revenge of the 5th be with you, Maddie.
Thanks, Maddie.
All right. Just a little teaser here. We've got another drawing from Chris for the next episode.
Do we?
Yeah.
Did I put it in there?
Yeah, you did. It's excellent. Are you taking out?
I'm deleting right now.
Swell. All right, that's it for our podcast. We're everywhere on the internet. Go to StarWarsNerdsUnite.com and check out links to all of our things. We're on a couple different podcast networks, Benview and Retro Junkies. They got some good stuff there. Check
them out.
We're
only like 7 emails behind now.
Behind our...
No, there's only like 4 or 5 on the document, and there's like 3 or 4 that I need to add.
No way.
Wow. Yeah. That's like...
People don't send in emails when we don't put an episode out for 4 months.
Okay.
It's not good.
Well, hey, we could potentially catch up.
Yeah, we could.
We could catch up.
We could clear
tomorrow.
The docket.
Wow, that's exciting. Are we? When does it come out? Monday or Sunday? It
comes out tomorrow.
Okay. Are you coming over tomorrow night then?
I could.
We got no Bears to watch, so.
An interesting thing I didn't mention. They're gonna. You can watch it. I said you could watch it on the Disney Now app. They're actually gonna release it like tomorrow at like 9 a.m. on the Disney Now app.
That's awesome.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
So I don't have to wait for it to air.
No. It's going to be on the app first.
Wow. So we can podcast whenever we want.
Except I will have a birthday party tomorrow and a soccer game tomorrow.
I thought you had one today.
We did. Today was the friend birthday party and tomorrow is the family birthday party.
Oh.
Nice.
And we didn't get invited to either.
You don't have a child who is between 5 and 7 years old.
But what about the family one?
You don't have any blood relation to me in any way.
You okay, fine. So you guys don't just have a normal party anymore?
I'm not involved in the planning process. I'm not on the party planning committee. I just show up.
Well then.
How did it go at the park district?
It's good.
All right, that's it for our podcast.
Yeah.
We're done.
Okay, fine.
Not forever. Just for today.
Just till tomorrow.
May the force be with you.
May the force be with you.
May the force be with you.
Doomed.
This podcast is a part of the Benview Network.
You can find this and other podcasts like it at BenviewNetwork.com.